think that if we are oblivious to this, we are oblivious to the level of the anti-Semitism as it grows in the United States, the danger from it, because there would have been no Inquisition without the Christian anti-Semitism, which we will go into. But all of the steps, all of the vocabulary, all of the caricatures of what it meant and what it means to be a Jew, what is wrong with us as Jews, how we do not fit into society, all of the imagery, all of the vocabulary, and the stereotypes are from day to day growing, and they are inside of our churches, they are inside of the media, and they, if you look now internationally, you have to look only at the Easter, the parades that are going to be in Belgium, that are in Holland, and that are now in Spain. And you look at the personification of the Jew as an insect.
Yes.
You look at the personification of the Jew as a pig. You look at the horrific personification of the Orthodox Jews, which now makes them the primary target of terror, of abuse, both in the communities and around the world. So yes, I see definitely, and I am not afraid to say it, because we as Jews, I am Jewish, and I made Aliyah to Israel, and I live there, but as Jews, we are the first to blame for not raising the alarm. And it was an honor to be asked by Lori to come and join this organization. But what I'm saying is, yes, I do believe that which we saw at the time of the Inquisition, we are seeing it again today. I was asked whether I think there will be another Holocaust. I really do not carry that language forward. The Holocaust, the Shoah, is the moment in history where extermination and the extinction of the Jewish people by Hitler, by the Nazis. It is a continuation of a cycle. So I do not look at this and project with the same vocabulary, because I will not minimize the Shoah, the Holocaust, but I will not at the same time say that what we see now in the anti-Semitism is not the medieval Christian anti-Semitism, which never went away, it was covered over, it has been made palatable, and now by the combination of the medieval Christian anti-Semitism and Islamist anti-Semitism, there is a free-for-all in Jewish blood. And that is what I see, and I do believe that.
Dr. Alfonsi, you do a lot of research for PJTN, and we are so grateful. Many of you are the recipients of that information on the context or the content in our children's K through 12 textbooks. We hear a lot about what's happening on our colleges and universities, the indoctrination of our children with this same rhetoric, the same propaganda, the same false accusation that Israel is an apartheid state. But can you share with our audience some of the content that you have found in reviewing our K through 12 curriculum here in the United States specifically?
First of all, I will have to say honestly that the biggest honor in my life was coming and joining Lori, because she allows me to speak and to write the truth of the work that I've been doing for 25 years. So the kavod, all of the honor goes to Lori for allowing me to speak. What I see in our textbooks, what I've been doing over the past 20 to 25 years on our textbooks, comes to a culmination today, I like to say, inside the textbooks produced by Pearson Publishers. There is a parallel, and what we're looking at as Judaism as a world religion, what we're looking at the falsification of the history of the state of Israel, what we're looking at the elimination of the contributions of the Jewish people to American history, we find this over and over. And I want to say one thing which you have to understand looking at it. I'm a specialist in language, and I pay a lot of attention to the language. We cannot say there were no Palestinians. That is the terminology of the region, and that is the historical entity. When the name of Judea was changed to Palestine, that is the terminology. There were the Jews who were the first Palestinians but there are, you cannot, and I beg you not to rewrite a revision of history. There was an entire body of Arab population in the same land. Therefore, to deny that existence, what does not exist is the false creation of a Palestinian state. But you cannot, and I beg you not to, totally eradicate those who lived side by side in a land that the Roman Empire tried to destroy and disconnect completely from the fact that the Jews were there biblically. We cannot do the same thing. What we are fighting against is the false creation of a Palestinian state with borders. There has never been the desire for a two-state solution. It is a one-state solution that the Arab League and all of these want. They want the eradication of Israel, and they will, hopefully, it will not happen, but that will be the moment when the word Palestine comes into existence. But in the textbooks, and what Lori asked me the question about the college campus, this is a phenomenon. This, what we see in the textbooks, is not a trickle down from the college campus. This started in K through 12, 6th through 12th grade. It started in 1975 with the first billions of dollars put in by Saudi Arabia into our education system here. And this is what you find the result in our textbooks. There is a marginalization. We have to understand that multiculturalism had a tremendous negative impact on our education system, and it did not have the impact that multiculturalism, which should have been equality, and putting together in the textbooks all of a way of developing our students to live in society. That did not take place. What we find in the textbooks today, we find there is the bias and slant on the Jews. There is a tremendous, and I'm saying this with a great deal of love, do not underestimate what is happening around the world with the genocide of the Christians. Because if we study what is going on and we take the word globalization, this started in 1975 slowly with the impact of Saudi Arabian money. And that was to completely rewrite the history, to draw the division between between America, the politics, the State Department, and through education, to sever the relationship between the United States and the State of Israel. And that has come to pass. Because if you wonder about a lot of the things that have happened in the Middle East to Israel, you have to go back to the politics of our State Department. And our State Department is virulently anti-Semitic, and it came through the money that was given, as an example, to Georgetown University. That's where our diplomats are trained. So these are the parallels that we find, and we find it today. And the other part is that if you remove the identity of the Jews, you can't, God forbid, we finish Hitler's work. All right, but if you remove from education the presence of the Jews, you remove from our education system how the Jews and the Christians in our country have interacted. Yes, over the years there have been anti-Semitism, there's been problems, but the textbooks now have removed, and it isn't that they made a typographical error, they have removed the unification, the unity between the Jews and the Christians. And then that went on with and this is the question of the terminology. This did not start with the terminology African American. It started with the Black Americans, then the vocabulary of African American came in, and now the Blacks are taking back their identity, and it is Caucasian and Black. But what the textbooks have done, and it is also part of the ancient, the medieval, the Christian anti-Semitism. They have brought the separation, a separation that was created with blood. And never forget, there was Jewish blood lost during the civil rights movement. There was the second president of the NAACP was a Jew for 10 years. There was Jewish money, all of that. but there were three civil rights workers killed in Mississippi, college students, one black, James Cheney, and two Jewish college students who died side by side. Those three died side by side fighting for the civil rights. Now, if you look at our textbooks, that is what is being eradicated. It is the globalization, and if you talk about globalization, there is one globalization, and this is what all of this is leading to. And when it's the globalization of Islam as the world religion, Pearson removed Judaism as a world religion. It was always Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, chronological order, and Pearson removed, we are no longer a world religion. We are in a category called others.
Yes. Mm.
But never forget, on the chopping block, you take off the Jews, you remove them out of the civilization, you remove them out of the textbooks, and you take them out of society. And then the next up on that line, and this should be a warning signal to you, the next up on the line are the Christians. And Pearson is brilliant in its evil. I mean, it's exquisite.
Thank you.
Because what they do is they use adherence, the number of people. And the difference between the number of Christians and the number of Muslims is not large. Look at Christian, the genocide today. Look at ISIS. Look at everything that is happening. And look at the numbers. It didn't seem a lot. You have 400 here, 1,400 here. If you start counting and you put it together and you look at reality, the reality is we lost 6 million Jews in the Holocaust. You go through from the Holocaust to now, the numbers of generations lost, we lost a lot more than 6 million.